I just didn't want her to have to go through what he has had to go through.
An Indianapolis family is celebrating a medical miracle just in time for Mother's Day. They're preparing to welcome their new baby, who will be free from a life-threatening genetic disease that's impacted their family now for generations.
Chelsea Helms with our broadcast partner CBS4 shows us how the couple used IVF to make it happen.
This sonogram represents a new chapter for Marcus and Callie Payne.
We're going to be parents, yeah.
You can hear the joy in Callie's voice as she prepares to welcome her first child.
Last year, I was grieving from the loss of our first round of IVF, and this year, I will get to have a baby, our sweet baby girl.
Hazel Sue is due in just a couple weeks. She was conceived via in vitro fertilization, a decision the Paynes made to ensure their baby would be free of polycystic kidney disease.
It is an autosomal dominant trait, which can lead to kidney failure and complications later in life.
I had my first kidney transplant, I believe at 15 or 16 years old, and then I had another transplant at 18 years old.
PKD is a genetic condition that affects hundreds of thousands of families, including Marcus's.
My grandmother had it, and then my dad had it, and he didn't really know he had it until they diagnosed me with it when I was born, because they knew it had to be genetically transferred.
But Marcus is making sure he doesn't pass it down to he and Callie's future kids.
We're kind of weaning that gene out of the family line, I guess,
yeah,
you could say.
I just didn't want her to have to go through what he has had to go through.
This is why the soon-to-be parents chose the IVF route.
If your parent carries it, the likelihood of a child inheriting it is about 50%.
It allowed them to screen their embryo for PKD prior to the transfer, ensuring their daughter won't inherit the disease. With the help of the PKD Free Alliance, the Paynes have spent nearly $60,000 to expand their family.
Without help, you know, grant-wise and stuff, I mean, we wouldn't been able to do all this.
It's an investment in their next chapter, marked by this Mother's Day, when they'll soon after become parents for the first time.
She's always been like dreaming of becoming a mother and like taking care of her own kids and everything like that. So I think it'll be exciting to see her do that, you know, become a mom.
Although she's not here yet, I'm still a mother, and I still, you know, have our sweet girl who we know won't have to suffer. And that's the most important part.